I think it's a very different kind of survivor. You know, so many times we are giving voice to those who are marginalized, giving voice to people who don't have one. And this woman, she beat her drum loud. Mm-hmm. And so instead of like Olivia fighting this crusade, she jumped on the bandwagon.
Yeah.
So they were partners in a way.
Yeah.
And, you know, all the intricacies and the complexities and the pushing and pulling and all these, you see what it cost the squad, what it cost the victims, what being believed means, how all we want in life, everyone, survivor, non-survivor, is to be seen. And so this is really a story about being seen, about being believed, and what it means, and how hard we fight in the shell that we put up because we're so fearful that we won't be believed. So it was kind of like beautiful. And I so enjoyed watching us chisel away at this tough woman that had encased herself and guarded herself and protected herself because she didn't think anyone would show up and she thought she would have to show up. And then it turns out that, of course, there were these angels that believed her. It's so beautiful. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I just love this story. I was so grateful. So grateful.
Yeah, and she really wouldn't give up. But she's getting beat up in that process. That's the other thing, is that even as she's plowing ahead and fighting and
she's
fighting,
she's getting beat up.
She's really taking hits right and left. And I think that's true for every woman out there that has really fought again and again to try to get their case heard and try to get justice, that they are very fierce, but they're taking a lot of blows in that process.
They certainly are. And it's all about right now, right, being believed. And fortunately, you know, television is a very, very powerful medium. And so to tell this story and to have people sort of let down their armor and really take a look at their judgments. It was such an incredible process for me and for Kathy because we did this together. It was such a beautiful collaboration with all of us and our team, but especially for us because we were the ones that were there in it every day during the shooting. And it was such a beautiful process for me to be able to do research and the time that we spent. For me, for example, I spent, you know, a few days and, well, maybe a week in an art studio trying. I'm not a painter. I'm not an artist that way. And to immerse myself into another world so I would understand that light, that freedom, to be able to have the visual language to portray that. And then we went to, you know, a strip club. And I'm sure you want to ask about that.
Yes, I was.
Who would not ask
about
that? Well,
you know, it was an incredible, incredible education. And so empowering, like surprisingly so.
And we had actual dancers that are there in the episode. And so you had, that we met that night?
We met women the night that we went, and we met these dancers that were so open and brave, but also just candid. And kind of wanted to share. And we're, quite frankly, I may be flattered that we were so interested in all the nuanced parts of their job. And we asked question after question, and it was such an education. And then we saw some amazing dancers that I thought one of them should be in the Olympics, as I told her. because she was just doing like things that defied gravity,
yes,
or
really,
anything
really
that was humanly
like
possible.
How do you go around the pole using neither your hands nor your legs?
It was so crazy what she was doing. And then we actually ended up asking her if she would be a consultant, and was so incredibly helpful. And it was such a beautiful collaboration.